Greetings, fellow citizens. Today we are testing the Anvil Hawk, another rule of cool ship. Let's call this ship a hawk and let's make it look a little bit like a hawk and give her tiny, flimsy wings that get lost easily and tiny, flimsy size 2 gun mounts that get lost easily too. Yeah, this makes total sense. And we are starting with one SAS-1 missile. Shields front side 71, stern at maximum. And the wings were already flashing, so the wings already took damage, but I usually only look for orange or red spots on the HUD. One SAS-2 missile. Shields front side 59, stern at maximum, and the shoulders were flashing again. But no cosmetic damage. One SAS-3 missile. Shields front side 53, stern at maximum. Two SAS-3 missiles. Shields front side 8, stun at maximum, and the right side is orange. One SAS-5 torpedo. Shields all around at 25, yeah. Missiles and torpedoes have a very small explosion radius since 3.0, only a very few meters, so if a ship is a little bit shorter or has a little bit shorter hitbox, all four shield faces are hit and all four shield faces are soaking up the damage. When a ship is a little bit longer, the stern shield might not absorb the damage, so this is a very bad game mechanic. I hope CHE will increase the damage radius of missiles and torpedoes again, like it was before 3.0. Two SAS-5 torpedoes. And as always, just for fun, one SAS-9 torpedo. The two memes explain why I do this, and I use missiles and torpedoes as my yardsticks. And Hawk is done in 3.7. Before I start, in my tests, I use ships in standard loadout and I use high alpha damage. This means ships with a lot of shield HPs like Aurora MR and Titan are looking good. However, depending on what you're fighting, you might be much better off with shields that have a higher region rate, no region delay damaged, that need less power or that are stealthier. And I looked into shields, links to my videos are in the top right corner. So for now, in my tests where I use high alpha damage and ships in standard loadout, the Hawk is about on the same level toughness wise as the Mantis and Cladius, and tougher than the Hornet. However, the Hawk is losing wings and gun mounts quite easily. Let's take a look at the comparison I've did of the Hawk from 3.4 when she was introduced until today, and between 3.6 and 3.7 nothing changed in regards to missile, gun, torpedo damage or shields, so those numbers are identical. Would I go into battle in a Hawk in 3.7? No, thank you. I don't like rule of cool ships. I guess most of you already know this. So what's the problem? ZHE called this ship a Hawk And CIG wanted to make it look a little bit like a hawk with those tiny flimsy wings and those tiny flimsy size 2 gun mounts. Problem is, those are getting lost easily. One of the reasons why is the hawk has shield holes, but that's not the only reason. It's just not a good idea to have flimsy and tiny gun mounts and wing mounts. Just look at real life, look at tanks and airplanes, those are rather compact. Because it makes sense, you don't want to have tiny things sticking out in all directions that have important things on them, things like coolers, things like engines, things like guns. So no, I don't like rule of cool designs. My rating for the Hawk and 3.7 is a 3 out of 10, which is clearly below average. As always, you can find a link to my spreadsheet, to my Locus data and a lot more useful guides in the description below. I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye, auf Wiedersehen. So, we are inside now. Let's get my gun. This looks just like any other cutlass. Here's the turret gunner. You can see his boots. And you can shoot at him. Run and you die. Fight and you die. He just disappears. You can't open the cockpit. Sadly. I don't know how, maybe you can glitch through it? Can I? I don't know how, maybe... Ah! Okay, I glitched through the door. And now we can kill the co-pilot and the pilot. Let's see. Okay, one less pirate. Big mistake. Yeah? Hey! I'm feeling kind of mean, but these are only NPCs. They don't feel anything. It's okay. So, I hope you've had fun watching this, and see you next time. Bye!
I decided to put this at the end of my toughness test videos from now on. If you already know this, then just skip it. So how tough is your ship? There are different factors and I start with the hard factors. How many shield hit points does the shield generator provide? What armor does the ship have? Right now all ships only have some generic armor values. And how many hit points do different parts of your ship have? Then we have soft factors. How big is your ship? How many shield faces are hit by an attack? And how easily are certain parts of your ship getting destroyed? For instance, some ships are prone to losing wing guns or wings. And then we have bugs. Right now we have a bug that the shields don't cover the whole shape of the ship, especially when the shape is elongated.